The legal woes have dismissed Bamban Mayor Alice Go piling up. The Justice Department on Tuesday filed an unbailable qualified human trafficking case against Go for her alleged connection with illegal pogos. This is on top of the tax evasion and money laundering cases she is facing. But the Pasig court, where the latest case was filed, needs to issue a resolution first, finding probable cause before Go can be ordered arrested.
Of course, it would be in our favor na hindi siya makawala. So we do hope na these warrants of arrest are issued in such a timely manner para wala na pong interregnum or interruption dun sa custody ni former Mayor Alice Guo.
Meanwhile, the National Bureau of Investigation found a signature mismatch on Go's counter affidavit and signature samples. Go earlier said she signed the document notarized by lawyer Elmer Galicia on August 14th. But the former mayor already left the Philippines in July. Despite the mounting issues, Go's camp is as optimistic she will still be able to walk free.
Most likely, tapos na yung kanya detention sa Senate, most likely magpupo siya ng bail para makalabas siya.
Philippine Vice President Sara Duterte claims Congress is setting her up for impeachment as a House panel probes how she spent government funds. Vivian Gulia reports.
Please your right hand.
Vice President Sara Duterte appeared before the House Committee on Good Government and Public Accountability, investigating her office's utilization of public funds, including the 125 million peso confidential expenses in 2022. But she refused to be placed under oath.
When you sent a letter to the office of the Vice President, you attached a copy of the rules in aid of legislation.
Yes po.
Yes sir. Nakalagay po doon na witnesses lang po ang inuot. Sabi niyo po ngayon sa amin resource persons kami.
Lahat po considered as a resource person and witness.
The Supreme Court says they are not the same. And somebody who appears to be the accused has a different tier of protection from a witness. And in fact, can refuse to take the witness stand.
Na witness.
Duterte asserted there was no misuse of public funds at the OVP.
There is no misuse of funds. We again leave the 2025 OVP budget to the pleasure of Congressman Martin Romualdez.
Her claim of leaving it to the House to do what it thinks is right is just a palusot.
2 p.m.
For Duterte, the House panel hearing is no ordinary legislative inquiry, branding it as a well-funded and coordinated political attack aimed at discrediting her to prevent future political contests.
You may try to destroy me. You can skin me alive and throw my ashes to the wind. But let it be known, you will find me unbowed. I will continue to serve the Filipino people no matter the personal cost or political intrigue.
She further accused the House inquiry of being a venue to prepare the alleged impeachment case against her. This was previously belied by House leaders.
Sa totoo lang, hindi naman ang budget ang punteriya ninyo. Dahil napakadali naman magtanggal ng budget. What you are trying to do is make a case for impeachment.
Wala po akong idea sa impeachment. Basta tayo, ginagawa lang po natin yung trabaho.
Inquiry?
Around noon, Duterte sought to be excused from the hearing, which was granted by the committee chairperson.
May I request to leave the inquiry?
Pwede naman po, considering na hindi naman din po kayo naka-out and alam naman po namin, marami rin po kayong ginagawa. The Vice President is excused.
But another lawmaker frowned at the Vice President's behavior.
The purpose of this inquiry is not to attack anyone, but to shed light on matters that affect our nation's governance.
After the House committee recommended slashing the proposed 2025 budget for the OVP by more than half, Duterte said the OVP will make do with whatever funding is allocated to it. While her name was not mentioned, the Vice President responded to House Speaker Martin Romualdez's statement that critics cannot point fingers and ignore their own misuse of public funds.
Malamang ako yon dahil tinatanong ninyo ako ngayon about sa kanyang speech at sinasabi ko kung ano yung ginagawa nila ngayon dyan sa loob, yan yung inilarawan niya sa kanyang speech. Nagtuturo sila ng daliri nila, ilang daliri yung nandyan sa loob ngayon.
Asked whether she will consider teaming up with the Marcoses again in the future, Duterte replied,
"Oh, never again."
The vice president said she and the president are not friends, adding that the last time they talked was when she tendered her resignation from his cabinet.
Hindi kami magkaibigan, unang-una. Nagkakilala lang kami dahil naging running mate kami.
When asked if she thinks a statement of support by the president could make the alleged political attacks disappear, she responded,
"Mag-share ako konti ng ugaling ko. Hindi ako humihingi ng tulong."
Vivian Gulia, ABS-CBN News.
Former Budget Secretary Lloyd Christopher Lau, a central figure in the Farmally scandal, released on bail following a brief detention. Lau was arrested in Davao City Wednesday, but he walked free shortly after posting a 90,000 peso bail. Lau was implicated in the anomalous procurement of medical supplies from Farmally Pharmaceutical Corporation at the height of the pandemic. He and former Health Secretary Francisco Duque were charged with violating the anti-graft law over alleged irregularities in the transfer of 41 billion pesos in funds from the DOH to the procurement service of the Budget Department. The Philippine National Police Chief launches a probe into allegations one of his predecessors helped dismissed Mayor Alice Go flee the country to evade arrest. The unnamed police chief was allegedly on Go's payroll. The allegation was made by a gaming official during a Senate panel hearing on illegal offshore gaming operators. There have been 24 national police chiefs who served before the current chief, General Robel Barbil. The national police spokesperson says they are now potential suspects.
There is no sacred cow dito sa gagawing investigation, even if it means holding liable ang isang former chief PNP. Mismo si chief PNP ang nagsabi kanina, wala tayong sisinuhin. Kahit sino pa siya, magpa-file tayo ng kaso.
Several former police chiefs have weighed in on the allegation. That was made by PAGCOR's Senior Vice President Raul Villanueva. Rodolfo Azurin Jr. says Villanueva's statement is irresponsible and uncalled for. Benjamin Acorda Jr. says it's unfair that a sweeping statement puts the integrity of former police chiefs at stake. Members of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ deny the existence of the so-called Angels of Death, the alleged private army of detained preacher Apollo Kibuloy. The group, allegedly comprising of military reservists, was said to have threatened Kibuloy's sexual abuse victims to not expose his criminal acts. But the KOJC says what they only have are prayer warriors. Kibuloy's media arm, SMNI, also claiming innocence after being tagged in the issue for its affiliation with Army Reservists.
Ay, dito to. Ay, dito to. Kasi the purpose ko is reservists, bawal man ang maghawak ng baril. Hindi na lahat yun dito. Hindi mo talaga totoo yan. Paano naging cases of death?
The Philippine National Police has begun profiling individuals, including some state forces, suspected of being part of the alleged armed group.
Membership ng Angels of Death ay hindi limitado sa civilian. There's also a possibility na baka merong mga retired or even active members ng uniformed services. I understand may mga lumalabas ngayon na mga list.
Let's get an update on the weather now from Pagasa forecaster Ana Clara Horda. Good morning, Ana.
Yes, good morning, Bettina. Currently, the southwest monsoon still prevailing over the whole Luzon and Visayas, and this will bring monsoon rains over Zambales and Bataan. Occasional rains is expected over Pangasinan, Tarlac, Pampanga, Occidental Mindoro, and Northern Palawan. Here in Metro Manila, Abra, Benguet, Nueva Ecija, Bulacan, Cavite, Batangas, Rizal, Oriental Mindoro, Romblon, Antique, Iloilo, and the rest of Palawan and Ilocos region, we're expecting a generally cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms also due to the southwest monsoon. The rest of Luzon or the rest of the country, we're expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers, mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. Currently, we're not monitoring any weather disturbance or low pressure areas that may affect the country. So for the next 3 to 5 days, we're expecting that this southwest monsoon will continue to prevail and affect most parts of Luzon or especially the western section of Luzon area. Then that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Anna Floren. Good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Anna.